I have downloaded real GDP per capita data for the US from 1947 to 2019. I'm interested in this question. Can I create a visualization that shows the average wealth of a person during the first 20 years of their life? And I want to know how that graph looks for each new generation. I'll create five generations, those born in 1947, 1970, 1980, 1990, and 2000. I'll plot the annual real GDP per capita for the first 20 years of their lives. Since I'm using real GDP per capita, I can compare living standards across time and generations. For the generation born in 1947, real GDP per capita at birth was $14,000 in real terms. Real GDP per capita increased to $23,000 by the time they turned 20. The 1970 generation started at $24,000 and ended at $37,000. The 1980 and 1990 generations had higher living standards across their first 20 years of life than the generations before them. Those born in 2000 started their life with real GDP per capita of $46,000, and today are experiencing a real GDP per capita of $58,000. Looking at this graph, it is evident that each generation in the US has a higher living standard than the generation before it. The economy might experience ups and downs throughout, but the overall long-run trend is positive. This is what we mean by economic growth. It is the long-run changes in wealth measured over generations. We measure it using real GDP per capita to capture differences in living standards. The reason we are interested in economic growth is because increase in wealth matters to other measures of well-being. There is a positive relationship, correlation between wealth, nutrition, educational opportunities, and even entertainment. Let us look at two categories of countries, the top 10 high income economies and the 10 economies with the lowest income levels. Real GDP per capita for the low countries is roughly $2,000 per year, compared to $47,000 for wealthy nations. Based on real GDP per capita only, living standards in high income countries are roughly 23 times higher. This translates to differences in other measures of well-being. The life expectancy is 17 years longer in high-income countries. On average, people only live to 63 years old in low-income countries compared to 80 years old in high-income countries. This also means there are differences in access to health. There are only 3 physicians for every 10,000 individuals in low-income economies, compared to 30 physicians per 10,000 people in high-income economies. Access to water and electricity are also limited. Think about your personal life. We often don't think about water or electricity access. We take those for granted. What is a basic human need in some countries is considered a luxury in other parts of the world. So economic growth matters. A historical view of economic growth in the world indicates that we really did not experience much growth till the 1700s. Before the Industrial Revolution, income per person remained flat. When incomes grew, so did the population, and therefore keeping average living standards constant. The Industrial Revolution helped real GDP grow faster than the population growth rate. While overall economic growth increased, the increase has not been even. Some countries are getting richer quicker. The per capita GDP in 1960 in the US was $18,000 in real terms. In 2019, India's real per capita GDP was $2,100. The standard living in the US in 1960 is roughly 9 times that of India today. Our goal in the next series of videos is to discuss economic growth. There are many reasons why different countries grow at different rates. This area of economics falls under development economics, and it is an important field of research.